Did you know that if you have a layout like this, maybe for a business card or an event name tag, and you need to populate that with thousands of names, QR codes, email addresses, or whatever, InDesign can do that. I'm Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to add QR codes in a data merge in Adobe InDesign. And you can also add other fields like name, address, title, and that kind of thing. All right, let's get started. Now I'm using VCard or business card QR codes, but I'm also going to show you how to do this with just a URL QR code too. Okay, so I've got this document set up as a 2x3.5 inch document with bleeds. When I hit W, you can see those coming right out here. Now, if you don't understand bleeds and why they're necessary, I have another video that shows what they're all about, and that'll be in the upper right-hand corner right now if you want to take a look at it. Now, this is actually more of an event ID card than a business card. The idea is to make this person's information easily accessible and shareable. So here's what happens if you use your phone to look at the QR code. It'll bring it up as a contact. So we could just come down here to create new contact and then go ahead and fill it out. But most of it is already there. Her phone number, email, and then her homepage, which is actually just her LinkedIn. So we can make a new contact this way. It's that easy with a VCard QR code. So obviously we're going to be changing out the name, the title, phone, and email. And this is where the QR code is going to go. Now I've got Pages open right here, and you can see the A parent will want to be double clicked on this A parent thumbnail. So right now we're in the parent page. Mine is the A parent. So I want to make sure that my first page has a little A on it, or that this parent page is applied. So if it's not, you can just click on it and drag it over to your page. Now we'll head to Google Sheets to get all of our information set up there for the VCard. So here's our data merge information for our QR code, which is the VCard. I'm using Google Sheets instead of Excel because Google Sheets is free for everybody. A lot of people might not have Excel. And also, sometimes Excel has issues exporting the CSV, which you have to do a data merge. So here's everything I'll need in the Google Sheet. We've got each thing that we want to come in on the card. And this top row of each column really matters. This is how InDesign can tell what goes where. And if you have a QR code, it has to be exactly like this in this cell. It has to have a pound symbol, QR space code, just like that. Now, if you only need a URL here, you would just add the URLs like this, and you would put it underneath QR code instead of this. To make a QR code VCard, the info has to be written a certain way. Each part of it has a code. There's in version, which version of the VCard you're wanting to use, FN, which designates the name, the telephone number, and it goes on from there. Now, this can be quite a process to get set up, but we can use ChatGPT to do this for us. So I'm gonna head over there. Now I've got a prompt for ChatGPT already written, and I'll just paste that in. So I'm going to ask it to put everything into VCard format. We're going to supply it with the info, and then I've got an example to tell it exactly what to do. I'll go back to my spreadsheet and highlight all the information, copy that, and then put that into ChatGPT. And by the way, I'll put this prompt in the description below so you can just copy and paste it. Then we'll enter that. Okay, and it's kind of doing the formatting a little differently than I want, so I'm going to stop it. Now I'll tell ChatGPT that everything needs to be on one line, and I'll give it another example. And I'll go ahead and push the arrow. And now it looks like it's doing better. So I'm just going to copy the code, come back to my data merge document, then I'll go to the cell beneath the QR code and paste those. And I've actually already pasted those in, so now we're ready to go. Next, we'll need to export the CSV file. So I'll go to File, Download, and comma separated values or .csv. And that is going to go to my Downloads folder, and I'll just drag it up into my working folder. Now I'll come back to my InDesign document. Everything I need is now in that CSV file, so we can go ahead with our data merge. Make sure you're on the parent page when you're doing this. We'll go to Window, Utilities, Data Merge. And here are some instructions on how to do this. They make it really easy by telling you exactly what to do. We'll come up here to the little flyout and choose Select Data Source. And we'll find our CSV file right here. And all of this is okay. So we'll say okay. And now we can see all the fields come in. Now, this is if you had a URL. I'm not going to be using that in this document. I'll click on the name field. I'm going to select everything and then click name. Same with the title field. And for phone number, I'm not going to highlight the text because I want the word phone to be on every card. I'll get my cursor where the phone number should go and click phone. And same with email. And then I'll get back on my selection tool. I'll click the QR code box and then choose QR code for that. Then you'll want to come up right here and click Create Merge Document. Let me zoom back out. We want to merge all records and we want a single record on each page. And we'll say OK. I get this little kind of pop-up and it says that no overset text was generated while merging records, and that is a good thing. But if you do have overset text, that means that some names are too long to fit in the box or some of the other fields are too long. So you'll have to find which pages those are. You can open the pre-flight panel and find where each error is easily that way, and then manually fix them if you need to. But we're good to go, so I'm going to say okay. Now you can see it's populated all of those records into separate cards. So let's take a look at them. So here we have Amelia Brooks's card. We've got her phone number and the email in, and her business card VCard QR code. Next we have Ava Fisher, digital marketing specialist, phone number and email, and her VCard in the form of a QR code. Now, if you have a bleed, when you export, you want to export as a PDF. We'll go to File, Export. We'll just call this VCards. We'll want Adobe PDF print, save, and then I always choose press quality here. And then in marks and bleeds, we definitely want the document bleed settings, which are already set up to 0.125, and export. And here's our PDF document with bleeds and has all the cards that were involved in the merge. So this is the document you want to send to your printer, although I did leave this die cut area up here. You might want to give them a separate file for the die cut and leave it out in this document. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.